Tadasana, mountain pose, in yoga is considered one of the blueprint postures and an important posture because it sort of embodies all the ideas of yoga. In the physical form, it not only grounds us to the earth, but it promotes this idea of lifting up towards heaven or the sky or the soul level. So inherent in the physical pose is this idea of both being rooted in the material world and going towards the spiritual world. It physically tones the entire body and improves posture. It creates space for your organs and it helps deepen your ability to breathe. On the mental, it is a pose that helps produce clarity and focus and concentration. So it's working the body, but it's also giving you a place to rest momentarily and focus the mind, which, as we know, is the key component to the yoga practice, is developing such a keen, concentrated mind that you can willfully drop into meditation and those higher states of peace and relaxation. Also, you'll often hear a teacher say samasthitihi when you bring your hands to your heart. That means standing in balance. So the pose promotes this idea of balance in the world, that both the feminine and the masculine sides of you are coming together, or the Shiva and the Shakti are coming together, or Ida and Pingala are coming together so that there's more energy up your central channel, your spine, Shushumna. Metaphorically, mountain pose speaks to our life. We have this hero's journey that we all have, and we've got to climb the mountain. And there's points along the way that we stop, and then we have to decide if we're going to go further up the mountain or not. Ideally, we get to the top of the mountain, and we have this vista where everything that has happened sort of falls into place. And we've got this higher understanding about why we've gone through what we've gone through. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Begin Shitali breath. Inhale through your mouth like you're sipping water through a straw. Exhale through your nose, down towards your feet. Inhale through your mouth like you're sipping water through a straw. Exhale through your nose, down towards your feet. Repeat that a few times, inhaling through your mouth with an O shape, exhaling through your nose down towards your feet. Shitali breath cools the system. And it's important to remember that at this time of year in particular, we want to be mindful that we're not overheating ourselves, that we're not practicing so vigorously that we're just literally getting that agitation of too much heat, excessive heat in the body. All right, extend your legs long if you haven't already. Flex your feet, keep your hands down by your sides. As you inhale, reach your arms overhead, point your toes. And you can kind of roll your thighs in a little bit at the top here. Don't be afraid to really roll the big toes together. This is that internal rotation that you were getting if you took constructive rest. And it might feel nice to widen the lower back kidney area. As you exhale, lower your arms, flex your feet, and turn your head to the left. Inhale, point, reach, head center, kind of roll your thighs in. And exhale, turn your head, flex your feet, lower your arms. So you're just going to continue with that for a few more rounds. Now, the kidney area in Chinese medicine is thought to really be the sort of organs that are in charge of vitality and vigor. So, if you are having issues there in that part of your body, it will can make you feel tired if you're not totally balanced. Think about as you roll those thighs in, spreading your lower back and sending breath, life, light to the kidney area, to the lower back area, kind of below your ribs and above your butt. Just all of that to gently encourage balance, restoration, etc. Two more cycles so you feel like you've turned your head equally from side to side.
Nice, Paula.
Okay, then we're going to, so come into a grounded Tadasana here. Your feet are flexed, your hands are by your sides. We're going to change it slightly. Inhale, arms overhead. So that's the same start. Exhale, flex your foot and bring your right knee to your chest, just the right leg. Inhale, reach it out, set your leg down. Exhale, knee to chest. Reach it out, set the leg down, and go slowly so that you're starting to work the hip, the knee, and the ankle, but also work abdominals. If you want this to be a little more challenging, go ahead and lift your body up so that your right knee and right eye are making some sort of a aligned connection. Soft shoulders, soft neck. If your neck becomes tired, just do the same work without lifting the head. You've got it. Good, Celeste. Now we're going to add another piece. As you bring your knee in, kick your leg to straighter, straightish. Bend the knee out. So it's exhale, knee in to the sky, bend the knee, inhale back out. And you can also continue to lift your head on these if you like. Don't force the straight leg. Think of this as still warming up. So now we're getting a little bit into the hamstring and the calf. Exhale. Now hold the leg straight, but slide your left foot in so your knee is bent. Lie back down. Right leg is long, left knee is bent. Bring your hands behind your head, glue your right elbow down. Exhale, twist to your leg, inhale, lower. Exhale, twist to your leg, inhale, lower. So let's just get the upper body going. Nice, Lori. Good, Rose. Keep your left elbow kind of back, so don't really reach the elbow across your face. Now we're going to add the leg. So we still do lift, and then when you come back down with your upper body, lower your right leg. Exhale, lift, cross, inhale, lower. Two. One, relax your upper body, lift your chest a little bit, find that easy back bend. Now, if your right leg is getting shaky or tired, just bend it a little bit. We're going to come in and get a nice juicy stretch, but for now, just we're leaving the leg up for the work. Good, Laura. Now, butt lifts an inch, another inch, come down just an inch, put it on the mat. Inch, inch higher, inch lower. Touch the mat. Lift a little bit more. So we're not even coming to bridge. We're just working the butt and the hamstring.
Lift a little higher, lower, down. Good. Lift, lift, lower, lower. You've got it. Lift, lift. Make sure your left toes are relaxed. Lift, lift, lower, lower. Lift, lift, lower, lower. Great. Come all the way back into long legs, palms turned out, legs turned out. Give yourself 2 or 3 moments of breathing in Shavasana. Let shoulders go, let neck go. So even when we're climbing the mountain, we stop, right? We create little camps along the way to stop, rest, and get ready for the rest of the journey. All right. Organize your legs so your feet are flexed, hands are down. Inhale, arms overhead. It's left knee to chest, exhale. Inhale, reach your leg out. Exhale, draw in. Inhale, reach out. Keep it kind of slow, which will make the abs engage a little more specifically. If you need more work, lift your head up. Exhale, remember, lose lifting your head if you need to. Good, Parbet. No rush on these. Good, Penny. 2. Now we're adding, if you like, leg lift to the sky, bend the knee, reach out. Again, you can rest the upper body and concentrate on the lower body, or you add the head lifting each time. Great. Hold your legs straight or straightish. Bend your right knee, hands behind your head. Just the upper body. Exhale, cross to the left. Inhale back down. Cross to the left. So warming up and getting some of that core work in at the same time. 4 more here. Now we're gonna add the leg. Leg goes down as your head goes back. Leg lifts as you cross. Four more. Keep your leg lifted, relax your upper body, lift your chest, relax your right toes, lift your butt an inch more, lower, tap down, up inch more, down, tap, yep, up, up, nice everyone, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down, up, up, down, down. 2 more. Up, 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 up. And totally rest. Keep both knees bent. Press your elbows down into the earth. Lift your chest. Engage the back of your arms. And then roll your head a little bit side to side. So just make sure that you're not engaging your neck too much. Press your head back into the earth without lifting your chin. A little engagement at the back of your neck, and then go ahead and lift your hips up. So those of you who never practice full shoulder stand, here's a way to safely get the benefit of a shoulder stand. You keep your chin level. You press your head, I don't know, 10 to 12% down, just enough to feel the back of the neck engage. Nothing dramatic.
And then kind of roll your shoulders back, press your triceps down so that you're toning not only the back of your arms and your neck, your upper back, but you're getting a little massage into the lymphatic glands around the armpits. Two more breaths. Lower your butt. Keep your left knee bent. Extend your right leg to the sky. Roll your right ankle around. Hold your right leg for the hamstring stretch. Good. Other way. Good. Now point your right toes and turn your right toes to the left. Now take your right leg to the left. Just a little. Now drop your left knee in like it's going to go to the right. Mm-hmm. Good deal. That's it. Theoretically, this starts to get us a little more into the outer hip. Now keep your right leg where it is. Drop your left knee to the left and turn this into a twist with your right leg extended. And you can just hold your calf, your knee, or your foot with your left hand. Make it simple. It's a twist, but a little bit more hamstring centric. Good. You might try flexing your right foot. See if that gives you more juice. Okay, bend your right knee, come back in. Left leg to the sky. Circle your ankle. Go the other way. Point your toes, turn them to the right. And then bring your left leg to the right. Drop your right knee in a little bit. Drop your right knee to the right, draw your left leg across, hold your knee, your calf, your ankle, or your foot, twisting with a little bit more emphasis on lengthening the hamstring. It might feel better to flex your foot here. Great. All right, turn and sit. Earlier in the week, we used a strap in all the poses to kind of find directions and length and engagement. Today, we don't have the strap, but I want you to hook your thumbs right into your armpits and then lift your chest up, kind of like what we just did in bridge pose. So I'm actually physically pulling the flesh of my armpits up, and then I'm rolling the front of my shoulders back. Reach your arms forward. Turn your palms to the sky, stick your butt out. You could call this a seated down dog. You could lift your arms up, which would be closer to a seated down dog with bent knees. You could call it a variation of Navasana. You could lean back and engage and try to lift your legs. You could hold your legs to do this. You can flex your feet. You can point your feet. You can keep your legs a little bit bent. All of those are options. Beautiful, Laura. Now, the one thing that you want to watch for in any of those options is that you're not rolling backwards, but you're maintaining this, which isn't Tadasana, more of this spinal extension, which is a back bend. Take another breath and then exhale, fold towards your feet. Let your head drop for a few breaths. You might even roll your head side to side a little bit. And then pause, bring one hand to that kidney area below your ribs and above your low back. So much healing power in your own hand. Feel your hand on your body And then send your big breath into this space. Know that as you breathe deeply, you're sending prana and energy and light to the cells, to your organs, to your blood, to your muscles, to your bones. Two more cycles of breath. And then rise up, flip around, hands and knees. Tabletop your spine. Reach your right fingers forward. Take your left toes back. Keep your left toes pointed. Inhale an inch up, an inch down. Touch, lift, lift, halfway down, lift, lift, halfway down, lift, lift, halfway down, lift, lift, spine is steady and straight, lift, lift, halfway down. Two more, up, up, down, down, up. Up, down, down, hold it up. Hold it up. Hold it up. Laura, draw your ribs in. That's it. Great, Paula. Great, Barbette. Good, David. Good. Exhale, child's pose. Again, find the fullness in this back area below the ribs, above the buttock. Come back up to tabletop. So it's not an arched back and it's not a rounded spine. It's a Tadasana spine, neutral. Everything's pretty long. Reach your right toes back. Keep the toes pointed. Reach your left fingertips forward. Lift up. Up, halfway down, up, higher, down, without your spine reacting, up, higher. So the spine doesn't change, it's just your limbs are moving off the central axis. Up, up, down, down. We have four. We have three. Two. Up, up, down, down, hold spinal balancer. Hold spinal balancer. Great. Good, Laura. Good, Lori. Great, Penny. Child's pose. Send breath into the lower back area, fill up. Inhale, slide forward, tuck your toes, lift your hips, down dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Now, this is a pose where you're really not filling up through the kidney area. If you want to look at me a little bit, I'm exaggerating. So a lot of us, myself included, have a tendency to pull the buttock under, and you'll see how this gets very filled out. Most of us aren't doing it like this. We're kind of doing that, just that little bit, right? Where we want the arch to go the other way. We want there to be a little bit of a lift up through the buttocks rather than a drop under. And sometimes that can also bring a lot of energy into the low back area. You might notice once in a while when you're in dog and you really get that tilt, that you feel a rising of energy from your low back all the way up your spine through your head. So, or you might get the energy like a feeling of lightness in the hips. All right, so keep either down dog with your feet totally glued down or come into plank. You're going to hold either position. Doesn't matter which one you choose. Right leg lifts. Exhale, right knee to your chest. Inhale, lift the leg. Exhale, right knee to your chest. So you could be in plank, knee to chest. You're not going to really round your spine. You're just bringing your leg as close to your chest as you can without changing. You're not floating to plank. You're either in dog or plank. Good. You're either in dog or plank. You're not going back and forth. That's it. Super strong. Good, Molly. This one's for you. Super strong too. Keep your head just slightly lifted, Dale, and you have it perfectly. Yes. And then it's a down dog. And then it's a down dog. Shift forward from down dog to plank. Lower your knees. Brighten your chest. Exhale, slowly lower through half chaturanga. Roll your shoulders back. Pull your elbows in. Press your hands down and spin them away from you as you find Bhujangasana Cobra Pose. Exhale, lower down. Keep the shoulders lifted. Inhale, lift up. Press your toenails down. Exhale. Inhale, hold Cobra Pose. Close your eyes. Today, squeeze your butt in. Sometimes if we go and contract in the buttocks and the lower back, we're going to get a lot of blood flow in that area, which will help also cleanse and clear the area. One more breath. Exhale, lower down. Press through half chaturanga. Reach your hips back. Take only two breaths in child's pose, giving yourself that tiny little rest before you continue up the mountain. Inhale, back, tuck toes, exhale, down dog. Find down dog. Just notice if you're not slightly pulling the butt under, let the hips tilt up. Choose dog or plank. Left leg lift. So you're not moving in and out of the pose. It's just knee to chest, leg lift, either in dog. Or same thing, holding a straight spine in plank. Great. It's four. It's three. Awesome. Two. Laura, amazing. Barbette, amazing. Good. Great. Love it, David. Down dog. Good, Celeste. Nice, Rose. Really nice placement with the arms. Inhale, shift forward, plank. This time you can keep your legs lifted or lower. Love what you just did with your head, Paula, with your neck. Exhale, lower down. Yes, Laura, you were right to make that. Good, Lori. Press your pubic bone down. Inhale, rise up to cobra. Love it, Penny. Exhale, lower down, but keep the shoulders elevated. Good. Rise up to cobra. Inhale. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, rise up to cobra. Hold cobra. Press your head straight back like we practiced in bridge pose. Press your head straight back. Squeeze your buttock in. Engage through your lower back and your buttocks, not to constrict, but to get some blood pumping through this part of your body. Take about three breaths, holding the contraction. And then lower all the way down to your belly. This is a great yin pose for the kidney meridian. Take your hands up to the upper corners of your mat with your hands turned out. Separate your feet a little wider and let your heels roll open. So when I roll the heels open, it's the exact opposite of what we just did. We're now really broadening that area. So keep the buttocks relaxed. And then lift your chest up a little bit. I want to show you this variation. This is a little easier on the back. So if I bring you all the way into seal pose, you're like, wow, I don't like it. You get to come back down on your elbows. Otherwise, go ahead and lift up into seal. Roll your biceps forward. Draw your head back. Relax your thighs. Let your heels widen. Let your butt really turn off. Allow, if you can, which is a hard thing to do in LA, to let your belly get softer. The softer your belly here, the deeper the back bend becomes. We're going to take about five more breaths. If you like that beginning Shitali breath, inhale through your mouth. Exhale through your nose. Inhale through your mouth. Exhale through your nose. Now keep checking in. Notice if your legs are trying to help you. Let them go. Then breath, exhale all the way down to your legs. One more. Come all the way down, make a pillow, rest your forehead on your hands, three breaths, totally letting go. Bring your hands back to your ribs, organize your legs, press to a full or a half push-up, tuck your toes, lift your hips, down dog. So with the weather being hotter, this is a pitta time of year when we want to make sure that we're not inflaming ourselves, literally or figuratively. But we still want to work. We still want to flow. Rise up high, bend your knees. So we can get all that. We just think of it like interval training where you're giving yourself just a little downtime before you start the next phase. Come up to the top of the mat. Inhale, take a half lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Hands to your lower back, roll your shoulders back, press your feet down, coming up with a straight back and straight legs. Good, good, good. Good, good, good. All right. Bring your hands to the back of your head. Without lifting your chin up, press your head straight back. Draw your ribs in, draw your elbows back, so that you feel your skull is over your tail, over your feet. One long line of energy. Now, bring your arms up, thumbs back. Then rotate your pinkies in, your thumbs out, and then widen your arms until you feel like you can maintain this Urdhva Hasta Tadasana. Okay, Laura, drop your heart. Soften your chest and draw your ribs in. Better. So, one thing that's important in Urdhva Hasta Tadasana, and if you look how easy it is to lose the kidney area and to make it a back bend. It is not a back bend. The kidneys are full, the ribs are back, the spine is straight. Urdhva Hasta Tadasana. Soften your chin. Whatever you're gazing at, imagine that you could gaze beyond it. Exhale, samasthitihi, hands to heart. Okay, we're going to build on this next part. So we're feet are in mountain pose, release your hands by your sides. Inhale, reach your arms chest level. Exhale, turn your palms to the sky and let your hands widen slightly. Inhale, reach your arms up, Urdhva Hasta Tadasana. Watch becoming a back bend. Keep the neutrality. Exhale, hands by your hips. Inhale, arms chest level. Exhale, palms turn slightly open. Inhale, overhead. Exhale, by your hips. Inhale, arms forward. Exhale, rotate the palms, open slightly, rise up, inhale. Exhale, take it down. Inhale, forward. Palms open, slightly wider. Lift up overhead. Watch that lift of the chest, Paula. Let your heart center be a little softer. You got it, you got it, you got it. Exhale, down. Adding on, inhale, chest level. Palms rotate open and overhead. As the arms come overhead, now begin to lift your heels. Exhale, lower your heels, lower your arms. Yep. Inhale, chest level. Exhale, external rotation, slightly open. Inhale, arms overhead. Watch back bending. Lift your heels. Exhale, lower down. You got it, Penny. Inhale, nice left reach. Rotation slightly wider, lift the heels as the arms come to Urdhva Hasta. Exhale, lower down. One more. Reach, open, wide, lift up. Hold here. Hold here. Great, Lori. Ribs in, just a little more, Laura. You know what it is a little bit, Laura, is you're pushing your thighs forward. Relax the top of your thighs just a little bit. That makes it hard. Good, Dale. Good, Celeste. Come on down. Shall we a little bit more? Yes, we shall. Reach your arms, inhale, turn your palms open, lift up, bring your heels up. Hold your arms here. Exhale, Utkatasana, chair pose, lower your arms. Inhale, reach your arms, straighten your legs, palms open, slightly wider. Lift up through the heels, arms overhead. Exhale, arms overhead, chair pose, and then just lower your arms, straighten up. Inhale, rotation, open, overhead. Exhale, chair pose, lower your arms, straighten your legs. Inhale, open your arms. It could be a little free, rise up. Chair pose, let your arms relax, swing through up, open. Rise, chair, swing the arms, open, rise up, chair, swing the arms, one more, open, rise up, chair, swing the arms, open, lift your right knee up, arms overhead, exhale, pass through, warrior three. Land your right foot to the right side of your mat, crescent or warrior one. Inhale, reach. Now what you're looking for, what I'm looking for, is not this, guys. It's not this. Oh, she said to step back, okay. Bop, 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 bop. Too much. It's just here, here, land soft. The work is in the soft landing. It's not where you get your foot. The goal isn't where you get your foot. It's the soft landing. Come back through. Warrior three. Knee to chest. Warrior three. Soft landing. Warrior three. Knee to chest. Warrior three. Soft landing. Let's see it. I'm seeing still a lot of a hit. It's not at all where you land on the mat. It's how you land on the mat. Metaphor. Better. Great. Great, David. Better, Dale, better. Better. It's putting us right up against it. It's much harder to do these transitions than it is to hold the poses. Great. And then let's meet in our Crescent Warrior One situation. Twist to your left. Swing your left arm behind your back. Bend your right elbow. You may or may connect. Go Mukhasana. I'm just adding a shoulder stretch here. And now go ahead and lift your chest up, but let your chin settle in. Focus your gaze forward or slightly up, but not all the way up. Reach both arms to the sky. Twist, place your right hand down. Come onto the ball of your right foot. Long spine, hold twisting lunge, or turn your feet to the left, hold modified Vashistasana side plank, or stack your left foot on top of your right foot for a full side plank. Great. Love it, Barbette. Awesome, David. Beautiful, Molly. Fantastic. Everybody looks Just great. Love what you just did, Dale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now, just give yourself a moment here. In dog, untuck the butt. Check in with your breath. Check in with your energy. Check in with how you're feeling. And really allow yourself to either hold dog or even come to a child's pose and make this a little more restful. Or if you feel like you want more flow, shift forward to plank pose. Lift your right leg up in plank pose. Just lift, hover the right foot. There you go. Keep your spine long. Turn your right hip down a little bit. Good, slightly lower your butt, penny ass, just a little bit. Exhale, lower slowly through chaturanga. Great, Laura. Inhale to cobra or upward facing. Beautiful. Head back, beautiful. Everybody, Celeste, awesome. Barbette, great, Ma. Exhale, downward facing dog. Rise high to the balls of your feet. Empty your breath. Come to the top of the mat. Inhale, half lift. Great. Exhale, fold. Inhale, half lift again. Bring your hands to your lower back area. Find a long spine. Whole half lift, Ardha Uttanasana. Let the kidney area be a little more buoyant. Feel your hands. Breathe in. Breathe out. Stand all the way up. Reach your arms overhead. Lift your left knee up. Exhale, pass through Warrior Three. Bend your right knee, soft landing. Warrior One or Crescent. Reaching back out into Warrior Three. Let your arms sort of do what they need to do. Lift your knee up. Passing through, the goal isn't where, but how. It's not where, but how. Remember that quote, you know, people don't remember you for what you did, how you made them feel, how you move through the world, not so much what you accomplish. Now, you may be more attached to what you accomplish. We usually are. But nobody else cares, really. Maybe somebody that you're in love with cares a little, or your parents or whatever. But really, at the end of the day, it's mostly us. All right. Better on this side. One or two more. We did about 8 passes. And there's also just something about giving your body this graceful, slow, methodical approach that allows the whole system to sort of calm down and reset. It's that samasthitihi balance idea. Twist in the pose. Send your right arm behind your back, left arm overhead. So a little shoulder opening. This is more of a back bend variation by lifting the chest, but let your chin soften so you're not overlifting through the neck. Heart is lifted. Soften your gaze, or imagine that you could gaze past whatever you happen to be looking at. Lift the gaze slightly, but not as high as the ceiling, just to the top of the wall. Reach both arms to the sky. Inhale. Exhale, left hand down, right arm up. Come onto the ball of your foot, twisting side lunge, which is still working this bottom arm, or modified Vashi by bringing the foot halfway down or all the way into side plank. And really, it's Tadasana on its side. Yes! Best, Dale. Paula, love what you just did. And just bring your top arm slightly forward, just a smidge. There you go. Perfection. Great. Great. Downward facing dog. Good, David. Do you need a rest? If you do, you do. If you took plank with one leg lifted, then consider doing plank with your left leg lifted. Great. You ate your Wheaties today, Barbette. I really see it. Exhale, slowly lower to the mat. Everybody looks good. Inhale, cobra or upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. Now, I'm giving you a lot of options here because I want you to all work where you need to work. You could take just the upper body flow, plank, chaturanga, cobra, up dog, 4 to 8 times so that you're moving and toning the upper body. You could hold down dog or plank. You're toning the upper body in stillness rather than in flow. You could go to a wall if you have it available in your space. Take a short down dog with your heels on the wall. This is a great way to increase flexibility in your hamstrings. Or you turn it into L pose. And now you're working a stronger inversion than down dog that requires a lot of arm strength. You could also turn yourself sideways. Take wide-legged forward fold with your hands clasped behind your back. Prasrita Padottanasana C. This becomes a softer inversion than dog and L pose. If you're holding rather than flowing, if you're holding a pose rather than flowing, you might return to Shitali breath, which is inhale through your open mouth, exhale through your nose. And I would do 8 cycles of that breath while you're holding whatever posture you're holding. Great, Dale. Really good. You're not dropping your shoulders in chaturanga. That's really great. Good, Molly. Awesome, Barbette. All right, those of you flowing, come to child's pose. Those of you in wide-legged, take another cycle of breath. And then we'll meet seated. Keep your knees bent, reach down, grab your big toes, lift up, pull your chest. This might be great for you. You may want to keep your knees bent and balance on your butt, a little more core work. You may want to expand your legs, lifting your chest, elbows pull in, biceps up. You may want to change this into a seated straddle. Bend your knees in if they're lifted. Walk a leg out. Walk a leg out. Exhale, fold in Paschimottanasana. Press the big toe side of your feet forward. Pull the pinky toe side of your feet backward. Now, I'm holding my toes, but you might be holding your calf or your ankle or your knees. Inhale, lift your chest up. Make your back feel as straight as you can, and then roll to the front of your sitting bones. So you're trying to maintain that arch in the low back. Then exhale, fold over again. Paschimottanasana, 2 straight legs. Press the back of your knees into the earth. Inhale, lift up just a little bit. Exhale, fold over your straight legs. So Dale, you can bend your left knee out for 8 breaths and then come back to 2 straight legs. if that feels better. Good, Lori. Right, so the softer variation of this pose would be legs up to the sky, less hamstring work, but more inversion work. Now, if you'd like to continue in Paschimottanasana, great. If you'd like to shift into wide-legged forward fold, great. If you're doing legs up to the sky pose, you might also just open your legs, support your legs with your hands for straddle on the back. So you can determine how you're emphasizing your flexibility work here. If you're doing wide-legged straddle on your back, I don't know, I usually find after about 10 breaths or so, it starts to feel like I'm working too hard to maintain. So come back to legs up. Those of you doing seated work, continue your seated work unless you want to do legs up to the sky pose. So if you know you like to do legs up or shoulder stand, come out of your seated work and onto your back. If you don't care, stay in your seated work a little bit longer. Now, ideally, if you're using blocks in Viparita Karani, legs up, waterfall pose. Let me face it like this so it's clear. So the problem with using one block is that you can see that my outer hips aren't totally supported. Inherently, most of us have a slight tilt one way or the other. And it's a pretty nuanced thing to feel. So if you just commit to two blocks for a broader base of support, now I'm getting equal support. And if I'm tilted a little bit, I really won't tilt because I have this baseline underneath me. So if you have two blocks, use two blocks. Not the end of the world, but why not? All right, inhale, lift your hips off of the blocks. Exhale, lower. Bring your right leg to the sky. Turn your right toes to the left. Scoot your butt to the right. Drop into this twist with the top leg extended. Bring your right hand into the area below your ribs and above your pelvis. And you might just massage back here. You might simply hold your hand and breathe into your lower back kidney area. But this twist with the hamstring stretch gives us a little bit more opening into all the tissues in the low back, outer hip, quadratus lumborum, glute med min, tensor fascia lata, and then of course the big IT band. In fact, I haven't done this one with you in a long time. If you hold your right hand and your left hand on your right leg and you lift up and you draw in, you get a nice opening through the right lower back. Come back through center. Left leg to the sky, point your toes, turn them to the right. Lift your hips, move them over to the left, drop into the twist. Hold your left leg wherever it feels good. Bring your left hand to your lower back area, massage or hold and breathe there for a few moments. Just know that when you do these little ideas, your body is receiving more prana, more light, more energy. And if you love that second piece, both hands to your leg, lift your head, bow in. Come back through center. Constructive rest, knees together, feet wide. Right elbow on top of left elbow, and then move into eagle wrap. Lift your elbows towards your face. Reach your hands towards the sky. 5 breaths. Inhale, open. Exhale, left over right. Palms touch, eagle wrap. Lift your elbows, press your hands, breathe. Relax your arms out. Relax your legs down. Let go completely. You made it to the top of the mountain, and now you're just lying down in some soft grass, taking in the sky above you, letting your body rest completely. Continue to rest or begin to deepen your breath in preparation for coming into a closing seat. So we have this journey to the top of the mountain, this one big long journey, which is our life. And then we have these journeys every year, and then we have these journeys daily, And we have them each time we step onto the mat to practice. It's a little mini climb to gain greater perspective, deeper wisdom, and to find balance and peace in the heart. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Namaste.